Howdy again everyone, and today I'm testing out another lens from Chinese manufacturer Viltrox, their new autofocus 85mm f1.8 STM EDIF lens for Canon RF mount cameras. It's available for $400, which is about £320 in the UK, which, as an autofocus lens, could make it a good value choice among Canon's official and much more expensive options. I have actually already tested this lens on Sony E-mount, where it put in a good performance for the money you're paying. Let's see how well it works on Canon RF mount, which is pretty starved for third-party lenses at the moment. I'd like to thank the Pergear company for providing a sample lens for testing, although as usual, this is a totally independent review. An 85mm lens with a bright aperture is blah blah blah, you know the drill already. The images they can produce are wonderful, offering fantastic background separation without breaking the bank. Everyone loves a bright aperture 85mm lens. This Viltrox option has a fully metallic body, feeling weighty and very solid, and it's based on a metal lens mount, which does not have a weather sealing gasket. However, there is a USB-C port on the back for firmware updates, which is always encouraging to see. I like the lens's overall look. The lack of a thick edging around the front glass element really shows it off, and its metallic body makes it feel like a luxury product. The body of the lens is dominated by a metallic manual focus ring, which is incredibly smooth to turn. Goodness knows what kind of lubricating oil Viltrox have used in the mechanism, but it feels absolutely amazing, and the focus motor responds to its use very precisely on my Canon EOS R5 camera. As you can see here, the lens exhibits some notable focus breathing, zooming in as you focus more closely. The autofocus motor works reasonably quickly, silently, and accurately, but it does pause for just an instant before finally locking on to your subject. It works fine in video mode and with eye autofocus too. I remember the Sony version of this lens sometimes did some focus hunting. Well, that didn't seem to be a problem with this Canon version. One thing I should mention is that I did notice a severe problem with the focus mechanism when shooting with my Canon EOS R5 in timer mode. As you can see here, it's going a bit haywire, and this happened when shooting in autofocus or in manual focus. I'm assured that that's going to be fixed with a firmware update. The lens has a filter thread size of 72mm, and it comes with a decently sized plastic hood and a thin cloth pouch. It does not have image stabilization, but it worked very well with the in-body stabilization of my EOS R5 camera. Overall, its build quality is tough, with confident autofocus and a nice finish to it. As I mentioned, it does actually feel like a luxury product. Okay, image quality. Let's have a look at how it performs on a high-resolution full-frame camera, my 45MP Canon EOS R5. Interestingly, the lens does offer you in-camera corrections. That is very unusual for a third-party optic on a Canon camera, so in this case, in-camera corrections are turned on. At f1.8, the middle of the image is impressively sharp with fairly good contrast. Corner image quality is definitely softer, but still perfectly good for most uses. Stop down to f2.8 for a little more sharpness and a lot more contrast in those corners, and spectacular sharpness now back in the middle. Stop down to f4 and the middle looks just as good, and the corners see another improvement, albeit a minuscule one. The lens stays this sharp down to f11, where a little softness begins to creep in due to diffraction. Overall, the lens's sharpness is very good, although it needs to be stopped down to f2.8 to really start flying on a 45MP camera, but anyone who owns a lower resolution camera than that will be over the moon, really. Alright then, let's take a look at vignetting and distortion on a full-frame camera. Now I've turned in-camera corrections off. Immediately, we see some pretty noticeable pincushion distortion, stronger than usual. Vignetting is about average, with darkness in the corners at f1.8, which is greatly reduced at f2.8, and at f4, just about gone. This lens can focus down to about 80cm from your subject, just average for this kind of lens, not very close really. At f1.8, close-up image quality is a bit softer, with sharpness and contrast being just okay. Stop down to f2.8 to see a nice boost in sharpness. Next, let's see how the lens performs against bright light. As you can see here, the Viltrox lens displays quite broad flaring when bright lights are in your picture. That flaring is not very well controlled here, so that is a bit of a weak point. Keep your lens hood on if you can. Let's take a look at bokeh. A lens like this on a full frame camera can get you some dramatically out of focus backgrounds. Generally, this lens's out of focus backgrounds are really nice and soft, although complex backgrounds can look a little jumbled. Related to bokeh is longitudinal chromatic aberration. Here you can see it's a little strong at f1.8, green bokeh highlights beyond the plane of focus and pink before. It's still slightly visible at f2.8, but at f4 it's almost gone. Overall, I really enjoyed testing out the Viltrox 85mm on my Canon EOS R5. It just works so nicely and feels so well designed in its handling that you quickly forget you're working with a third-party lens. Bearing in mind the lens's good sharpness, nice bokeh, and affordable price, I think most people will be pretty delighted with it, and it's good value for money too, so it comes recommended. Thanks for watching, all you Viltrox fans out there, and, well, everyone else. I hope you enjoyed this review and found it useful. If you did, then please consider supporting the channel by checking out my Patreon page down in the description below. Supporters on there get all kinds of exclusive content that I love putting together for them. Take care.